Let's consider this problem of finding the distribution of xy when x and y are independent uniform variates, right? So it is given that f of x is equal to 1 in the interval 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 1, 0 otherwise. It is a uniform variate, right? 1 by 1 minus 0 is the function, and f of y is equal to 1 in the interval 0 less than or equal to y less than or equal to 1 and 0 otherwise. F of x comma y is f of x into f of y. Since the variables are independent, you have 0 less than or equal to x comma y less than or equal to 1 and 0 otherwise. Now you should find the distribution of xy, right? Let us take the following transformations. U is equal to xy and v is equal to y, which implies x is equal to u by y and y is equal to v, which again implies x is equal to u by what is y, v, and y is equal to v. So this is the transformation you are going to consider, and for this you can compute the Jacobian of transformation: dou x by dou u, dou x by dou v, dou y by dou u, dou y by dou v. Dou x by dou u is 1 by v. Dou x by dou v minus u by v square. Dou y by dou u 0. Dou y by dou v is 1. So you get 1 by v. Talking about the range, x lies between 0 and 1 implies what is x? It is u by v, right? And y lies between 0 and 1 implies what is y? It is v, right? Now from this you can understand, considering this part, 0 is less than or equal to u, that is u is greater than or equal to 0, and considering this part, u by v is less than or equal to 1, that is u is less than or equal to v. Considering this part, you have v greater than or equal to 0, and considering this part, you have v less than or equal to 1. You should incorporate all this information in the graph to find the region of integration. Let us do that, okay? See, I am going to represent u values on x-axis and v values on y-axis, right? Now, what is this line called? This is v is equal to 0, right? And you need a line v is equal to 1. Let me draw it. V is equal to 1. V should be less than or equal to 1 means this is your area. V should be greater than or equal to 1 means this, greater than or equal to 0 means this is your area. U is equal to 0. See, on this axis u is equal to 0. U greater than 0 means this is your area. U less than or equal to v. First, you consider it as an equation to plot the line. U is equal to v. 1, 1, 0, 0. Okay. Now, 2 points. U for u is equal to v. 2 points are enough to draw a straight line. Draw this and name the equation as u is equal to v. But you consider, you should consider the area in which u is less than or equal to v. Take a testing point 1, 0. If u is 1 and v is, if you put u is 1 and v is 0, the inequality is not satisfied, right? U should be less than v. So this point does not satisfy the condition. So this region cannot be your region. So your region is this. So your graph is now speaking. Your graph says your region should be above this line, below this line, to the right of this line, and above this line. So this is your area. Right? Fine. Now let us find g of u comma v, which is f of x comma y into modulus of Jacobian. F of x comma y is 1. Jacobian, modulus of Jacobian is, j is 1 by v. So if you want h of u, right? H of u here, because u is your xy. Remember, u is your xy and you need the distribution of xy. H of u. You should integrate g of u comma v with respect to v. What is the range of v? This is the range of integration, right? You should integrate from this line to this line. These two are the guiding lines, okay? From this line, v is equal to u. to this line, v is equal to 1. So you're integrating which function? 1 by v dv. 1 by v when integrated gives log v, right? U to 1. So you have log 1 minus log u. You know log 1 is 0 minus log u. So let us now summarize. H of u is minus log u. In the interval, what is u? It is from 0 to 1. Your graph says x u ranges from 0 to 1, right? So 0 less than u less than 1. 0 otherwise less than or equal to u less than or equal to 1, right? So this is how you find the distribution of the product of two independent random variables. Okay, this is your answer. Thank you.